In this demo, we want to focus on some fundamental CAD features in ARES Commander to show you how they compare with AutoCAD. We will keep for the next demo the most advanced features, such as dynamic blocks, data extraction, and 3D. ARES Commander offers all the 2D tools you would expect, from 2D entities to entity features, and of course, all types of dimensions. You can easily try these features yourself. To begin with, I'd like to direct your attention to the Design Resources palette, which is the equivalent of the Design Center in AutoCAD. This palette helps you to reuse contents from other DWG files. You can copy from there styles, layers, or layouts to reuse them in the drawing. Let's focus on the blocks. With the palette, you can reuse the blocks from other drawings on your computer. But also from other opened files, and from any DWG shared on the network. Blocks created with AutoCAD or ARES are the same. If I double-click on it, I'm launching the block editor and can modify the block definition. ARES Commander also supports blocks with attributes. Let me show this nice example. It is a closed polyline, and inside we inserted the attribute of the area. When I modify the polyline, the attribute will reflect the new calculated area. This information can also be found in the Properties palette, but we also see the block has another attribute that is hidden, where we can enter a name for the space. If you're familiar with attributes in AutoCAD, you probably know the command ATTEDIT. If I enter this command, an alias calls the corresponding command in ARES. So there is really no surprise here. Let's talk about layers now. Fundamentally, there is no major difference. The name in AutoCAD is Layer Manager, and in ARES it is Layers Manager. Just one letter is different. The Layers Manager can be used as a side palette, or kept as a floating dialog if you like. In the ribbon, we have some interesting layer tools. For example, we can isolate the layer of the selected entity. Or select the active layer by selecting one entity. Just like in AutoCAD, the Layers Manager is used to create and manipulate layers. The challenge with layers, however, is that you can quickly end up with a very long list. In AutoCAD, there are two features that help you with that. One of them is layer states, and we have the same here in ARES Commander to switch between different configurations of layers. The second one is the layer group filter that you see here as well in ARES Commander when you expand the palette. Now, ARES Commander goes a little further with layer preview. It enables you to select one or more layers and explore the content of these layers. It helps, for example, when you receive a drawing from someone else and want to understand which layers are interesting to keep for the work you have to do. After the preview, you can keep the configuration or return to the previous state. Now, let's talk about hatches and gradients. Just like in AutoCAD, we can make a double click on any hatch or gradient to edit their properties. If I select this contour, I see I can change it, using, for example, the grips, and the gradient will adjust accordingly. Finally, a nice trick to learn is that you can copy the hatch properties to other entities. In all these examples, the dialogs you have seen can sometimes look slightly different, but they are essentially the same, and there is nothing new to learn. To conclude, I would like to show you some unique productivity features of ARES Commander. Now, let me show you the Power Trim command. The Trim command works the same in AutoCAD and ARES, but with the Power Trim command in ARES Commander, you can do it much faster. And if you combine with the Shift key, it becomes Power Extend. Another of my favorite features in ARES Commander is the Dimensions palette. If you go to the Annotate tab, you'll find all kinds of dimensions. Most of the time, I would use Smart Dimension, which is a very intuitive way to get quick dimensions. Now, pay attention to this icon when I select a dimension. I use it to call a small palette to customize the texts, precision, and tolerances. After using it here, I can select another dimension and apply the same style. Finally, if you liked these features, you could add them as shortcuts to the mouse gestures. Try to hold the right button of the mouse and go in any direction. The mouse gestures wheel appears with 4 or 8 shortcuts to your favorite features. To customize these shortcuts or disable this, you can enter the command Gestures in the keyboard.